I'm pretty sure that he got like in a lot of like hassles because of that, for sure. مع الأمن العام. I'm pretty sure.
Have
of
you,
what you
Tony?
can say and no.
Actually, I have not, Nour.
Wow, that backfired.
Honestly,
I've read some of his scripts.
Yeah, the script that we're planning to film, we sent it to the أمن العام and the fucking العميد هنيك المسؤول عن ال, to read the scripts and give them approval. He called us and he was like, "This is the best thing he has ever written. He has ever read. Okay. This is the best thing he has ever read." He had absolutely zero remarks and he gave us stamps on all 140 pages.
Sorry to interrupt. I had no idea that when you write the script, you need to send it into Amn al-Am. I had no idea.
Of course.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh.
When you get... But, when you when you're about to film, you need a permit. You need a an approval to film. So we
from the area that you're filming.
Yeah, we were planning to film last year in Lebanon, yani. So we needed a permit from the
as a filmmaker, doesn't that fuck you up a bit? Like, okay, I could write this brilliant artistic masterpiece, and no offense to the guy who's running this division in Amn al-Am, but maybe he might miss the point.
Full offense. Full offense.
Yeah.
Full offense.
the guy's like a probably 60-year-old guy.
Exactly.
Who's watching a few of these like musalsalat on LBC at like 10 p.m.
It's scary that guy needs to accept your script.
That's the only form of creative input in his life.
Guys, to be fair, I've heard some assuring stuff from there.
Okay.
It's not as archaic as we think. They're very negotiable. They can reach compromises. Ultimately, يعني بعد ما تخلص تصوير الفيلم بدك تاخذ الفيلم وتقعد تحضره معهم. And they will give you notes and you can convince them and you can fight for your
what
stuff.
What notes will
them.
They give you?
They're not that much of dictators. They're not tyrants, yeah. يعني, as we think they are. Yeah.
But I have a different example of that. Because of after you film something, you have to show it to them. So, BBC, I used to write for them for a while.
Yeah.
And the satire show. And then I wrote it into a bit in my stand up, but I never used it. Like, because you do realize, other than these security divisions, religious groups come in, بيمثلوا دار الفتوى والكنيسة that watch this. So the funny part about it, I asked one of the shuyukh in that department, I'm like, so you are responsible for what you think is sexually too explicit. Like in the, والله, is that something is for too long explicit, they think they should cut it down بالسينما بلبنان.
Yeah.
I asked the sheikh, he's like, okay, why are you banning it was a movie like Bad Girls 2. Altilo Sheikh, مش انت you banned Bad Girls 1. Why are you giving Bad Girls 2 another chance?